Tyrannosaurus rex, one of the most recognizable and fan-favorite dinosaurs, once ruled the lands of North America during the Maastrichtian Age at the end of the late Cretaceous period, approximately 68 to 66 million years ago, across an area stretching from Canada to as far as Mexico. Back in the day, it shared the subtropical and semi-arid plains with various other dinosaurs, including other predators. However, none of them could rival the T-Rex in its dominance, establishing it as the apex predator of its ecosystem. But what were the keys to its success? Tyrannosauridae, a closely related group of Coelurosaurian theropod dinosaurs, emerged as dominant predators towards the end of the Cretaceous period. This group is divided into two subfamilies, the relatively slender and slightly earlier Albertosaurines, represented by Albertosaurus and Gorgosaurus, and the larger, more robust and later Tyrannosaurines, which include not only Tyrannosaurus rex, but also other genera, such as Dasplotosaurus or the Asian Tarbosaurus. Yet their origins extend as far back as the Middle Jurassic period with the superfamily Tyrannosauroidea. Initially, they were small and agile carnivores, measuring only around 2 to 3 meters. It was only until the end of the Cretaceous period, after approximately 100 million years, that they evolved into the colossal size of a T-Rex, the largest species of them all. In fact, the name Tyrannosaurus rex itself translates to tyrant lizard from Greek and king from Latin. The remains used to describe this dinosaur were discovered in 1902 in Hell Creek Formation in Montana by an American paleontologist, Barnum Brown. Just 6 years later, Brown made another significant discovery, also in Montana, a nearly complete skeleton identified as AMNH5027. Which is still on display at the American Museum of Natural History in New York. Despite the fact that only about 30 skeletons of adult individuals have been discovered globally, the majority of them are nearly complete. This abundance of well-preserved specimens has provided scientists with the opportunity for in-depth studies of this intriguing animal. One of the T-Rex's remarkable features is its massive and exceptionally robust skull, which could measure beyond 1.5 meters or 5 feet in length. Its formidable jaws were equipped with about 60 serrated teeth, reaching up to 30 centimeters or 12 inches, including the root, the longest in the dinosaur kingdom. Combined with powerful jaw muscles, the animal could deliver a powerful bone-crushing bite, unleashing a bite force of 35,000 newtons. Equivalent to 7,868 pounds per square inch, more than double that of the saltwater crocodile, which currently holds the highest bite force among living animals. Much like other megatheropods, T-Rex featured powerful hind limbs that were built to support its substantial weight. Despite having muscular legs, these creatures were likely not optimized for speed. A 2021 study utilizing computer simulations based on tail movement determined T-Rex's walking speed to be approximately 4.6 kilometers per hour, or 2.9 miles per hour. Sprinting estimates vary significantly, but the majority propose a top running speed of around 19 kilometers per hour, or 12 miles per hour. Moving any faster, the animal would be in danger of shattering its bones under its own weight. Originally, tyrannosauroids possessed longer three-fingered forelimbs. However, as they continued to evolve into massive sizes, their hands shrank in size and retained only two functional digits. Paleontologists have long debated the reason for this reduction. One theory suggests the limbs were used to grab onto females during mating, while another proposes they assisted the animal in lifting itself off the ground. Although the T-Rex's arms may seem small in proportion to the rest of its body, they were in reality comparable in size to those of a man and possessed significant strength. While other theropods such as Spinosaurus or Giganotosaurus surpass T-Rex in length, the Tyrant King still holds the title for the largest predatory dinosaur ever discovered, at least in terms of body mass. Research indicates that T-Rex achieved its full size in approximately 20 years. At the young age, these animals were more agile, slender, and possibly covered with some form of feathering. However, as they matured, they traded their agility for sheer power. The largest specimen ever discovered, nicknamed Scotty, measures 13 meters or 43 feet in length and is estimated to have weighed around 8,870 kilograms or 19,555 pounds. Nevertheless, recent studies, based on incomplete skeletons, propose that certain individuals might have grown even larger. However, their size was not the only reason for their success. Thanks to advanced medical scanning techniques such as computed tomography, scientists can now uncover secrets hidden within the T-Rex's brain, providing insights that were previously unattainable simply by examining the bones themselves. Distinct brain areas, referred to as lobes, align with specific senses. The larger these lobes are, the more developed the corresponding senses become. Recent findings revealed that T-Rex's brain had notably large optic and olfactory lobes, indicating an exceptional sense of sight and smell. The eyes of an adult individual were the size of grapefruits, positioned forward, set wide apart and high on the head, providing excellent depth perception. Its impressive sense of smell surpassed that of any living species today, likely enabling the detection of carcasses across long distances similar to modern vultures. Speaking of long distances, in addition to its outstanding vision and smell, its inner ear was adapted to detect low frequencies, providing an advantage when tracking prey. Fossilized feces of tyrannosaurs and the remains of other dinosaurs, preserved with tooth marks caused by none other than T-Rex, prove its capability to easily bite through and digest the bones of other animals. This ability likely allowed it to prey upon anything that lived alongside it, including ceratopsians, hadrosaurs, armored ankylosaurs, and possibly even sauropods. Some theories have suggested that T-Rex might have lived and hunted in packs. However, there is no substantial evidence supporting these ideas. Such suggestions were primarily made by comparisons with its relatives, Albertosaurus and Tarbosaurus. Instead, it is believed that these animals were highly territorial. An adult individual required a lot of space to survive. Recent estimates indicate that each adult had a territory spanning approximately 40 square miles, equivalent to around 100 square kilometers. Given its massive size, this species had no natural predators. Their only concern was the presence of another Tyrannosaurus, and rightfully so, as certain bite marks found on the bones of Tyrannosaurs have been interpreted as evidence of cannibalism. If you've made it this far in the video, you've learned about the key features that truly earned the T-Rex its rightful title as the king. However, there's one aspect we haven't touched upon, an intriguing theory that suggests that the T-Rex might not have been as formidable as originally thought, potentially acting more as a scavenger, feasting on dead carcasses. But more about that another time.